Hey there, it's me Abby with Metal by Abby, and I'm here to help you figure out if that piece of jewelry you have is real silver or something else. So step one, easiest way, I think, you look for a maker's mark. So a lot of times they'll be like on the tongue of the clasp or something like that, near the chain or on the earring. So that's your first step. If you see something like 925, STER, 800, 999, those are silver stamps. You can also look through my blog and I have them all written down. Another step is to use a magnet. Now, a magnet is attracted to anything that has iron in it. So this is a stainless steel earring back and it is magnetic. So that works. This is a sterling silver ear wire and it is definitely not attracting anything. There is one caveat, and that is with clasps and lever backs, anything that has a stainless steel or a tool steel spring in there. So you've got the spring for the lever back. It's just jumping out of my hand. And even though this is a silver earring back, it's gonna attract the magnet because of the steel spring in there. Same thing with the clasp. So if the clasp is attracting the magnet, but the rest of the piece is, that is not, does not necessarily mean that it's not silver. But it is a way, if the whole piece is sticking to the magnet, it's not gonna be silver. All right, we have another trick. This one's kind of fun. Ice. So I have a sheet of metal here that I know is not silver and a sheet that's very dirty and I know is silver. They look very similar, but silver is a really great heat conductor. So when you put the ice on the silver, it's gonna look like it's like just immediately melting, like it's heated up. And you can kind of, I like to do one side by side to see. The other thing is that all the way across this piece of metal, after about 30 seconds or less if it's smaller, the whole thing's gonna be cold like right away. And it's kind of just like a race, right? You could do it by taking a piece of ice and setting a piece of silver on top of it. And then take your piece of non-silver and set that on top and see which one sinks in faster. That's another way to tell. So the stainless steel is not gonna conduct the heat as quickly. So you can see here, I've got a bit of a puddle for this one and not much is really going on with this guy. I know this is a much bigger piece. It's very thin. That doesn't really have any bearing on that. So you've got the ice trick. Another fun way to tell is just pick it up and smell it. I think we've all handled loose change before and it has this stinky coin smell. Silver shouldn't have a smell. Sometimes it might, if it's like really tarnished, have a little bit of a stank to it, but real silver doesn't have a smell. And then two more ways. You can just try polishing it. So if it's silver, you can get a new washcloth, I mean not washcloth, polishing cloth, and kind of buff it. And look at your cloth and see that it's turning black. If it's doing that, it's removing the tarnish and you know that it's silver. If it's not silver, it's not gonna do that. You might get some surface dirt, but it's not gonna really be doing the same as for the silver. It gets a lot darker. I recommend too, just as a side note, if you're trying to polish your silver jewelry, go for something that's made for like silverware, flatware. It has chemicals in it, just like the silver jewelry cleaners, but it's so non-toxic, you can use it on things you're gonna eat off of. So I think this is a much better option than those really nasty jewelry cleaners. Also, I think it works better and it leaves an anti-tarnish coat. All right, the last tip is the easiest, but maybe the most time consuming. You can always take your piece into a local jeweler and ask them for confirmation. I mean, if you bring in a whole pile, maybe they're not gonna do it. It depends. There's a lot of nice jewelers out there most of the time. But if there's a piece you're really curious about, bring it in, ask them, they can help you out. So thanks. If you have any questions, let me know. Sign up for my email on my website for more tips and tricks, and I'll see you guys around. Ask me any questions. I'll be on here to answer them for you.